White. He was singing hard band. Amen. Thank God. Every time I see them, it takes me way back. You know, my mother used to sit out there and watch me and make sure I was doing what I was supposed to be doing. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you to this Tree of Life Youth Ministry. And I could do better than that.
First off, we won't be having any Wednesday night service for the remainder of the year. And we also won't be having any Thursday night choir rehearsal as well for the choir. Our Sunday school ministry will be meeting this coming Friday, December 23rd at 6 p.m. via Zoom call. I don't know if you guys got the little, some of you may have like the hot chocolate with the little scan QR code. All you have to do is scan that code and that'll log you into the Zoom call for this Friday night. So this first Sunday will be Christmas Day, and we will have one service at 10 a.m. There will be no Sunday school class, and we're encouraging everybody to come out and spend Christmas with us.
Amen.
And also, today, this Sunday, is Pastor's Love Offering. So please encourage our pastor and sow into him and his ministry. Amen.
Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
First of all, I would like for everyone to continue to pray for Sister Bill and Brother Bill.
Yes.
A lot of you may not know, but the passing of Akil Mills. Akil was one of the longtime members here. She had a baby. She was a baby. I mean, very talented young lady.
Yes.
And young.
Amen.
So quit saying you got time. You don't know, have time.
Stop time.
But please pray for them because my sister's really going through a lot. She's really, you know, a lot of people put on for some, just like that young man took his life. Nobody knew what he was going through. But you can see the smile in your face, but you don't know what a person is going through. And quit saying that, and especially in the black community, about mental illness. Quit saying that there's nothing wrong with you. There's something wrong with you, because if you're having suicidal thoughts, something's wrong with you. I'll never forget Yolanda, my sister. She told me, she said, girl, you're nothing wrong with you, you need to pray. I was going like, yeah, I prayed. And I did pray. But I was still having suicidal thoughts. So I went to the psychiatrist. And she told me, she said, ma'am, the reason you're having suicidal thoughts is because you're over 50, and now your elevation of height goes up. She said, there's nothing wrong with you. You're not crazy, nothing. Is that when you get to a certain age, some people that they just get that. So she told me I couldn't drive over like high bridges. Didn't know you drive on the freeways, but I went back and I do that. But don't say that. Keep saying, call your people because you're never the
people.
You don't know. The sister Willamette told me song to song, this may be my last. I don't know. Yeah. We don't know.
That's real.
We don't. So if we ever needed the Lord before, we should. And I cannot get the image out of my head because I never saw her. I haven't seen her. She was always at work. And I cannot get that image out of my head. To see your child, it is nothing you can do for
me.
And God is so good. She was sitting down. I was in the store. And I looked out and I came out and I was calling her name. And as I approached her, her eyes were rolling to the back of her head, foaming at the mouth twisted.
Wow.
And I didn't know where these four angels came from. They prayed my daughter to the Amalek, with my daughter, to the Lord. And they prayed her out of that seizure.
Thank you, God.
So I thank God for angels that continue to pray the Lord.
Glory
to the Lamb. Everybody will say, "Joy to the Lamb." We sing glory to the Lamb. We give all glory to the Lamb.
To the Lamb.
Yes, we sing glory, glory to the Lamb.
To the Lamb.
This is why.
For He is
and only,
only
forever is He.
Before Jesus died, there was a veil that was in the temple that the priest had to be translated through in order to offer sacrifice for the sin of man. And when Jesus died, the veil was torn. And today, every last one of us have, thank you, there it is, can come boldly. There's an old hymn, and the choir's going to sing and move out the way. Why should I feel? Why should the shadows? Why should my heart? Y'all helping me with the words. And long. Come on. When Jesus is my constant friend, is He His eye? Is on the spot. I know. I sing because I'm free. His eye is on the, and I know that he watches. Come on, quiet.
Thank you. reverence to Almighty God. Pastor Goss, Pastor Lewis, and these preachers. The gospel. My brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus. Today is a good day. We celebrate the last Sunday of Advent. The last Sunday of Advent. And just thank God for another day.
Yeah.
On top of the ground, it's in the ground, we're on top of us. And if you're present, thank God for the present of being present. He's given us the gift of another day. There's reason to tell him thank you right there. I want to thank God for Pastor and Sister Mars. They're taking a vacation. So can we praise God for them getting a good time today? And can we bless God for the awesome job that they've been doing since they met? It does not yet appear what God is going to do through the ministry of Pastor and Sister Morris. We thank God for that. I stand here today charged by God, persuaded by His Holy Spirit to preach His uncompromising gospel, to tell a dying world about a risen Savior. Come now realizing I'm just a nobody. Trying to tell everybody about somebody that can save anybody. The table is spread and the feast of the Lord is going on. Whosoever will, let him come. The Gospel of Matthew. Matthew chapter number 1. Matthew chapter number 1. Matthew chapter number 1, starting in verse number 18. Still have pages, John. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Mary, her husband, being a just man, not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary, thy wife. For that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. The grass withered, the flower faded, but the word of our God shall stand forever. You may be seated in the presence of our God. Now, I did not have a subject for this message until a few minutes ago, and God spoke to me through those children. So our subject this morning is Let Earth Receive Her King. Let Earth Receive Her King. My brothers and my sisters, since the dawn of mankind, estimates say that there have been 88 billion people born on this earth. And over that span of time, there have been some amazing, dynamic, extraordinary individuals that have been born. January 17, 1942, float like a butterfly. sting like a bee. Muhammad Ali was born. August 29th, 1958. You know I'm bae. You know me. You know the king of pop, Michael Jackson, was born. June 19th, 1957. Get ready, get ready, get ready. Bishop T.D. Jakes was born into this world. May 19, a person that said, we didn't land on Plymouth Rock. Plymouth Rock landed on us. May 19, 1925, Malcolm X was born. Here's a birthday everyone should know. June 15th, 1929. I have a dream that one day my four little children would live in a nation where they would not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King was born. Here's one that I put in for the young folks. August 24th, 1986, person who said these words were born. Kiki, do you love me? Are you riding? There you go. Drake was born. Some truly talented, amazing, gifted, courageous individuals who have made tremendous contributions to mankind.
Yes, sir.
And we thank God for all those that have been born, and thank God for your birthday. But there has been no birthday that will ever compare to the birthday of Jesus Christ. His birthday was prophesied some 700 years before he actually came. I'm number 8 of 9 children. I wasn't a planned pregnancy. I was an old baby. But Jesus' birth was talked about long before he got here. The Bible says that the Lamb was slain before the foundation of the world. You all must have got preaching. Pastor just preached it last Sunday. For unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given. And the government shall be on his shoulder. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Because in the mind of God, he was already born. He already died on Calvary. And he already got up on Easter Sunday morning. His birth, it changed time from B.C., before Christ, to A.D., Anno Domini, in the year of our Lord. The time that was would never be anymore. His birth only changed time, but it changed the trajectory of mankind. Because mankind went from annihilation to celebration. Because now his birth is celebrated all over the world. And listen, y'all, it's not about Christmas trees and lights and Santa Claus and Secret Santa and White Elephant and mistletoe and eggnog and magic pajamas or Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. It's all about Christ. Don't forget who the celebration is about. Don't take Christ out of Christmas. It seems like everybody gets a present on Christmas except for the one whose birthday it actually is. At my birth, my parents named me David Scott Taylor. And I didn't get the opportunity to ask Mama why she named me what she named me. I like to think it was after King David. Because David was the eighth child of Jesse, and I was the eighth child of my mama. And Pastor Lewis, his mother named him Milton. What's your name? Named after Dad Milton Lewis. And whatever your name is, your parents named you your name. But listen, ain't nobody bowing at the name David Scott Taylor. And nobody bowing at the name of Minister Milton Lewis Jr. But the Bible says at the name of Jesus, every name must bow. Everyone must bow. Every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. At his birth, the heavenly host formed a mass choir in the sky and began to sing, "Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, and goodwill toward me." Here in chapter 1 of Matthew, we have the genealogy of Jesus. We get all those begats. Abraham begat Isaac, and Isaac begat Joseph, and Jacob begat Judas, and David begat Solomon, and Solomon begat Rehoboam, and so on and so forth. And in verse 16, it says that Jacob begat Joseph, the husband of Mary, of whom was born Jesus, who is called Christ. It does not say Joseph begat Jesus because no one begat Jesus, because he's the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Now, after all those begots, after 42 generations, verse 18 says, now. I like that because now represents a shift in the atmosphere. Because God is about to do something that's never been done before. Take a baby and turn this world upside down, inside out, in every which way but loose. Verse 18 says, the birth of Jesus was on this wise. In other words, this is how it all went down. Jesus' birth, first of all, was natural. Because he was born of a woman. Now all of us in this morning have a mother that carried us for 9 months. Thank God that he chose women, because if it was up to men, wouldn't be no babies. And God has uniquely equipped women for the task of childbirth. It just comes naturally. And the best method is natural childbirth. Labor is shorter, healthier for the mom and the baby, shorter recovery time. The only method they had in those days was natural. So Jesus was born of a woman. And the one who spoke spinning worlds into existence allowed mankind to hold him in their hands. He was a baby, just like any other baby. He cried. He had to get his diaper changed. Can you imagine Jesus getting his diaper changed? Joseph changing him and tells Mary, "Mary, what you feeding this baby?" He had to be birthed just like any other baby. He had to learn how to walk just like any other baby. Can you see Mary? "Come on, Jesus. Come on, baby Jesus. Come on, JC. You can do it. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus." Just like any other baby. And now that baby is all grown, sitting on the right hand of the Father, interceding for us. And now when you are going through, he's pulling for you. You're sick, you can't take another step. He's saying, come on, baby. You can do it. Feel like you can't go another further. He's saying, come on, baby. You can do it. And he's pulling. He's now pulling for you. Bad report from the doctor. He's saying, come on, baby. You can make it. Friend turned their back on you. He said, come on. You can do it. Family let you down. He said, come on. You can make it. And if you fall, he'll be right there to pick you up. You may be wondering, why did God do it the way that he did? Through a baby to save the whole world. Simply to identify. We don't serve a God who's out of tune, out of touch with everything we go through physically, emotionally, psychologically, physically. Because his son experienced it all. Also, the life of Jesus represents the life of a Christian. We all start out spiritually as babes, as children. But here's the problem. We start out as babes, right? Here's the problem. Too many of us are still on milk and not meat. Look at 2 Corinthians. Talk about milk and not meat. Chapter 3, 2 Corinthians. First Corinthians chapter 3. Look at what Paul said. I have fed you with milk and not with meat. For hereunto you were not able to bear it, neither yet now are you able. For you are yet carnal, for whereas there is among you envying and strife and division, are ye not carnal and walk as men? The stuff that tripped you up 20 years ago shouldn't still be tripping you up today. That hit me when I wrote it. Jesus didn't stay a baby because the text says that Jesus grew in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and man. Tell your neighbor, grow up. Here's the point, y'all. It's natural because we really are spiritual beings living a natural experience. So God sent his son in the natural to help us get back to the spiritual. Not only was Jesus' birth natural, it was also unnatural. The text says in verse 18, when his mother, Mary, was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child. I remember when my daughter came to me and told me she was pregnant. Gonna have a baby. My first reaction was, no. And I asked her, how could this happen? I said, Daddy, oh really? Duh. How could this happen to me. Better be a child of the Holy Spirit. The circumstance of Jesus' birth were unnatural because it did not happen in the course of normal human interaction. Being espoused meant that Joseph and Mary were essentially married, but there was a 1-year waiting period from the time that they were espoused to the time they actually lived together. And I would imagine that Joseph would see Mary in town from time to time. He would see her. 4 months he would see her. He would say, "Mary, picking up a little weight." And 6 months in, he found out that she was pregnant. And Joseph, you are not the father. Now understand, Joseph loved Mary, and he's understandably heartbroken. How could she do this to me? And by law, Joseph had every right to publicly disgrace Mary, divorce her, and even have her put to death. That would have been the natural reaction to get my lick back. But Joseph's reaction was unnatural because the text says in verse 19 that Joseph was a just or righteous man. And not willing to make her a public example, but he minded to put her away privately. And Joseph was righteous, and to be righteous is to be in a right relationship with God.
Yes.
There's a difference between being righteous and being religious. Because anything you do regularly is religious. You brush your teeth religiously. You take a shower religiously. We drink coffee religiously. Go to work religiously. Some of us even come to church religiously. That don't make you righteous. We know Joseph was righteous because he had the wherewithal. Listen, he had the wherewithal and the opportunity to get back at Mary, but didn't take it. And when you have the wherewithal and the opportunity to get back at someone that hurt you and don't take it, that's next level in God. Godly love is not wanting to hurt those who hurt you. He didn't want to hurt Mary. He was not willing to embarrass her publicly. He was going to put her away privately. Everybody ain't got to know your business. Some stuff needs to stay between you and the Lord. When you're going through, when you're down, some folks will pray for you, P-R-A-Y, for you. But other folks will pray, P-R-E-Y, on you, and try to take advantage of your situation. And we can learn something from Joseph in this lesson, because the situation, some situations need thought and deliberation and godly counsel. Take it to God first. Because verse 20 says, while he thought on these things, Joseph said, I need to sleep on this one. And while he was sleeping, God spoke to him. Because life is full of decisions, and without godly guidance and direction, we really don't know what decisions to make. And when you're hurt, when you're angry, when you're frustrated, for most of us, usually the first reaction is not our best reaction. Say, when you're hurt, frustrated, angry, usually your first reaction is not your best reaction. I know that. With my wife and I, we've been together 30 years. And, Pat, whenever we have a disagreement, that's a nice way to say argument. And we going back and forth, and she'll say, I can't talk to you. fine. I can't talk to you either. We just have to get apart from one another.
Yeah.
And just take time to cool off and to think on it.
Yeah.
And sometimes when you're angry, upset, it's best sometimes to just take a break. Because you don't want to say something that you might regret. And you know what we'll do? I'll go upstairs, and I'll go downstairs, and we'll take some time. And when we come back together, and after I apologize, everything is all right. For the young couples, guys, just go and apologize. Go and apologize. It is your fault. Is that right? Anybody been married for longer than 20 years? Any fellas? What the fellas in? Am I right?
It works every time.
Listen, y'all.
Yes.
Talking about taking time with God.
Yeah.
Taking time to God.
Yeah.
When we pray, we are speaking to God.
Yeah.
When we pray.
Yeah.
When you pray, you speak to God.
Yeah.
But when you get in His Word, when you get in a text,
yeah.
He'll send you text message in the text.
Yeah.
He speaks to us through text. To text message. He speaks to us through text. Have you ever been involved in a one-sided conversation? Person just keep going on and on. You can't get a word in edgewise. You just start shaking your head. Yeah. But thank God He doesn't stop listening to our prayers. He's just saying, if you'll get in the text, you'll see I already answered what you're praying about. If you're crying, if you get in the text, it tells you weeping may endure for a night. But joy coming in the morning. If you're troubled in your mind, I will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on me. It's in the text.
Yes, sir.
If you lost your joy, this is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. It's in the text. If you need healing, He heals all our diseases. It's in the text. You need provisions. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. You need prosperity. He make me lie down in green pastures. You need protection. Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. It's in the text. Maybe you just don't feel good. All things work together for the good. I tell you, it's in the text. God spoke to Joseph and told him, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take Mary as thy wife. Now Job, the only other person in the Bible, the New Testament, referred to as the son of David. God is reminding Joseph of his royal ancestry at a critical moment in salvation history. to remind him that he has a divine vocational call on his life.
All right.
Wow. And I stop by and let you know that you too have a call on your life.
Yeah.
And can I tell you what your call is? You are a chosen generation.
Yes.
A royal priesthood.
Yes.
A holy nation.
Yes.
A peculiar people. That you should show forth the praise of him that called you out of darkness into the marvelous light. Now listen, Joseph thought he only had two options. Divorce Mary or have her stoned. But God said, I have a third option, Joe. Take her as your wife. Now I know what it looked like. I know people gonna talk about you.
Yeah.
I know it's unnatural.
Yeah, you
may be ostracized and criticized.
Yeah.
But God is telling Joel, I want you to trust me.
Yeah.
For I know the plans that I have for you.
Yeah.
Plans of peace and not of evil.
Yes.
Because my plans don't always work out. But God's plans always work out. For my good. His birth, it was natural, it was unnatural, and lastly, it was supernatural. In verse 20 it says, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. Every man born after Adam was born in sin. So God had to bypass the bloodline. So he provided himself a seed in a virgin, Mary.
Yeah.
Now for God's plan to work, it required sinless blood, a perfect sacrifice. Now while in the placenta, in the womb, the mother's blood never mixes with the baby's blood. Now he was fully human because he was from Mary's womb. He was fully God because he was conceived of the Holy Spirit. It's no coincidence that Christmas and Easter are the two greatest holidays. Because Jesus' conception and his resurrection are the greatest supernatural events in human history. And supernatural is an event attributed to some force beyond scientific understanding are the laws of nature. I don't always understand how God does what he does the way that he does it. This is why it's above my pay grade. But the how is not as important as the why. And verse 21 tells us the why. I like this translation. She will bring forth a son. You will call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Your will must line up with his will. Jesus is his name, and Christ is his title. Christ means the anointed one. Jesus means the Lord saved. Put them together, the anointed one, the Lord saves. Can I get a witness? For he saves from the guttermost to the uttermost. He saves. I know he can save because he saved me. Because I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peace for sure. Very deeply stained within, sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea heard my despairing cry. From the water lifted me, now safe am I. Love lifted me. That baby grew up and he healed the sick. Unstopped deaf ears, gave sight to the blind, and raised the dead. That baby grew up and one Friday he died. He died. He died. He died. On a rugged cross, the centurion soldier cried out, surely, 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 he was the Son of God went in the grave, stayed there Friday night, Saturday night, but early Sunday morning, before the dewdrops faded, early before the rooster crowed, early he got up with all power. His birth was natural, unnatural, and thank God it was supernatural.
It's all right.
Here's the point. Don't get nothing else. Here's the point. He did all of that to save you. I think we should
call it Christmas
instead of Christmas. The original name of Christmas was Christ. It was Christ Mass was the original name. And over time it got converted to Christmas because they wanted to take Christ out of Christmas. Sad to say, some churches not having church next Sunday because it's Christmas. How you can have a party and not invite the person whose birthday it is? A party for me not invite 95 me to the party. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Mr. Taylor, for the word, for that word. Don't take Christ out of Christmas. It's not about happy holidays, it's about Christ. It's not about giving and exchanging gifts, it's about Christ. And so we ought to keep Christ in Christmas. Amen, amen. The doors of the church are open. Go to the church open. Ask our officers to come.
When nothing else could help, the Son gave His life.
Yes, He did.
The Son gave His life. When nothing else could help, the Son gave His life, so I can live.
Whatever. The doors of the church open. If somehow a visitor has came in here, the doors of the church open. We
We stand to you, the author, the love of Christ.
Accept or to reject. We have our sister coming for you, coming for prayer.
Praise the Lord to all my sisters and brothers in Christ. To my enemies, if there be any. Thank y'all for praying for me on last Sunday. I was admitted in the hospital for 2 days. I lost my sight. Thank God. I got my sight back. What the devil was trying to take me, but I'm not giving up. I'm gonna keep on running. That had been needed in voice for the GI. So I'm just asking for prayer for her.
Amen. 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 We're gonna continue to pray for you. And we want to continue to pray for Sister Beale because you just don't know. Like her sister say, you can put on a good face, but you just don't know. We're going to pray for Sister Davis, for your daughter, still praying. And let's pray for one another. If you don't need prayer right now, one day you will need it. Guarantee on this road to glory, if you don't need prayer right now, there will come a time when you're gonna need prayer. So let us pray one for another. Amen. Before we close, the youth are having a luncheon in the fellowship hall for the children. It's for the children. I totally emphasize it. It's for the children. Anybody over age 18, are you still considered a youth at 18? Are you? Okay, all right. Over age 25. But they're having it for the youth. Let's encourage the youth. Let's encourage these youth. Can these youth, can they do good today? Amen. That's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. If we don't encourage them, we shouldn't talk about it. Let me say that again. If you can't encourage the youth, you shouldn't talk about it. Don't talk about them being no good. They could have did this. They didn't do this. If you didn't encourage them, you part of the problem. Amen, amen, amen. Nothing else will stand. Can we all sing that? Can we all sing that? I know you know it.
him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding great joy. To the only wise God, our Lord and Savior, be dominion, power, and his name forevermore. Let us all just sing together. Amen. Amen.